Maine's highest court has ruled that jury selection for the trial of a man charged with promoting prostitution in Kennebunk can no longer be done in secret anymore. Good evening, and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The Portland Press-Herald fought a judge's decision to block members of the media and the public from the jury selection process in the Mark Strong trial. The state Supreme Court has now sided with the newspaper. Strong and Alexis Wright are accused of running a prostitution business out of a Kennebunk Zumba studio, and they have both pleaded not guilty to all charges. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live from Alfred and has more with this report.
Mark Strong sat in court as his lawyer argued against a motion to prevent the defense from talking about the personal lives of police officers during this trial. Defense lawyer Dan Lilly says the police were after Strong because Strong was investigating the Kennebunk cops.
The motivation of the lead investigator in this case, of investigating this case and calling in every agent, every conceivable federal or state agency, was not for the purpose of law enforcement, but was for the purpose of stopping a guy that was getting a little close to unprofessional conduct in their department.
Lilly says the hard drive where Strong was compiling his evidence vanished after the police seized it.
It had the investigation that Mr. Strong was doing on the Kennebunk Police Department on it, and it was never to be found again.
Prosecutors say whatever Strong was investigating had nothing to do with his arrest.
So these alleged investigations, discoveries by defendant Strong, these are matters that happened in 2009 or 2011 before this investigation began.
Justice Nancy Mills ruled that the defense can cross-examine the lead Kennebunk police officer regarding her personal life. Also today, the defense tried to get Strong's invasion of privacy charges tossed out.
I don't believe that anybody can make a rational argument that people who are breaking the law, namely having sex for money and have admitted it and have been adjudicated guilty, are entitled to privacy so that they can commit their criminal acts.
Prosecutors say the people who visited Alexis Wright, whether it was just once or in one case 42 times, had a reasonable expectation of privacy.
A place where someone goes to engage in sexual activities is a place they expect to be free from surveillance.
No ruling on the defense's motion to drop the invasion of privacy charges. The judge simply took it under advisement. We are told the jury selection will continue on day 4 tomorrow at 8:30 a.m. Live in Alfred tonight, Paul Merrill, News 8.